And welcome back to the Morning Drill. 8:45 is our time on a Thursday morning, 11th day of May. Joining us this morning is Kelly McDonald from the Drakewell BMX. Kelly, good to see you this morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to the program. Welcome back.
Yes.
Been a little while. Was that last year?
It was last year about this time, yes.
Really?
Well, maybe it was a little bit later in the season. So.
Holy smokes.
I know.
Time just flies. Well, what's new? Catch us up on what's been going on with the Drakewell BMX.
Well, there's been a lot of excitement that we've had going on last year. I've moved up. I'm now the president. I'm no longer the secretary.
Well, I am. You know what?
I don't know if that's
We didn't have the red carpet out for you. I'm so sorry.
I know. New shirt, new position, the whole nine. So,
well, congratulations.
Yes. Thank you. Yeah, we've been doing a lot on the off season, and that's kind of the excitement that we have going on.
Okay.
BMX doesn't go through the summer. The board works hard all through the winter preparing for the season. So,
What is the season?
The season actually starts on the 21st. That's our opening day.
Okay.
And then we race until the end of August. Wow. That's the official racing season. So prepare your schedules and plan on showing up on Sundays. But in the whole off season, we've been looking at a lot of things to make things better for our riders, to make things better for the community, to make things so that it's a little bit more workable for everybody. We've been working really, really hard on doing some things to, the last 2 years has been a lot of rebuilding and replenishing and refreshing. That's what we've been doing for the last 2 years. We've done a lot of improvements to the property. We've done a lot of improvements to the facility. If you haven't been down there, the announcing tower is completed. We had our dedication. It's beautiful. And that was towards the end of the year. So that piece and the siding of the building, that has made a huge impact on that facility. It has made things brighter and cleaner. It has made our announcer one happy person because now he can see the track. He has a roof over his head, so whenever the sun is beating down on him, he's not standing in the sun, or if it starts to drizzle, all of our equipment stays dry. So
is this the tower here on the screen?
Nope.
No, that's not it. Okay.
Nope. It has the Oil Creek Plastic sign on it.
Oh, there it is.
Yes, there's the
okay.
announcing
now
tower.
Now that's beautiful.
It is. It's a very beautiful construction that we did. And that piece and the siding was generously donated by Oil Creek Plastics. We were able to stretch that money so far, and we were able to buy a new PA system. So, like, we stretched that one donation into three.
Wow.
So we really did a great job of making that money last. So we did that. And then if you go back to that dual picture that you had up there before, that one. That's just another improvement that we made. And like the railing on the right matches the railing on the tower. So we've made some things like that was what it looked like before. And so we've made it a little bit more user friendly. The railing now is going to be painted because now that's weathered and we can put some paint on it. So just those kinds of things make the facility a little bit more appealing, and it all is cohesive and everything is matching and it all looks good. So we've done a lot of replenishing, like I said, replenishing, refreshing, renewing. That was the push for the last 2 years. And so the hard labor is done. So for those people that have been waiting for that work to be done, most of it is done.
Wow, congratulations.
Yeah, we're really excited about the work that we've done.
So it's time to have fun now.
It is. It's really time to have fun. And I'm really, really excited about that. And that's what our next push is to get more riders and to get more volunteers. Because I think that a lot of the work that everybody was seeing us doing, everybody was like, let them do it. And which is okay, because the group that did it, we were okay with doing that. We had a plan, we had a vision, and most of it is completed. And so now we're taking a lot of what we had been building, and we're doing now what we're calling reinvesting. And like I said, we've kind of had this 3-year plan in place, and now it is about reinvesting in our families and in the community here. We've had amazing community support from the businesses, the community, organizations, clubs, all of that. And without that support, we would not be here. And I cannot say enough about what everybody has given to us. And now what we're doing is we're giving back to our riders. Luke, I think you have a picture of some bicycles. Can you put that up? That is one of our reinvestments that we're doing. And those bicycles that's a reinvestment that we've made. We have taken some of the money that has been donated to us, and that is a fleet of rental bicycles. Those are race bicycles.
Oh, wow.
And what DK, which is one of the bicycle manufacturers that works, there's a lot of different bicycle manufacturers, but they have a program with Trax that they offer discounts for Trax that want to offer rental fleets. A lot of kids, when they want to come down, they're kind of intimidated because you can ride whatever bike you want, but when you show up and you see kids that have a race bike and race gear and helmets and all of that, it's pretty intimidating. So we wanted to offer the opportunity for a rental bike. Also gives families an opportunity to try before you buy. And this has been a successful program at other tracks, and so we wanted to take some of the money that we have, reinvest it in ourselves, reinvest it in our kids, and give them the chance to say, hey, this bike fits me, mom and dad, can you do this? It also helps us to interact a little bit better to say, that's not the size you want, try this one. Because a lot of families are like, I don't want to spend all that money on a bicycle. So it gives them the chance to really test this out.
So it's kind of like when I took a kayak to a yacht race, I just looked around and thought, I am not in the right place.
Well, even if you think about it, look at Ty and Esta with all those places that have kayaks. You know what I mean? You can try those before you go out and plunk down a few hundred dollars. It's the same concept. We also have at our track, we have helmets that you can use. You know, a lot of kids just don't want to use the ones that they're using whenever they're out riding their bikes on the streets. We have those there at the track. We also have a push to have a lot of our veteran riders re-donate some of their gently used stuff so that we can outfit those kids with gear so that they fit the part. I can't tell you enough. Whenever my son first started riding, I can tell you this awesome story. My son loved riding immediately, and so he had a race bike, but he didn't have the race gear. And my boyfriend went to World of Wheels and bought him a jersey. He didn't have pants, but I remember the day that he took the bag and he threw it at him, and he had the shirt, and the look on his face when he felt like he fit in. And that's what we want for those kids, is to feel that they fit in. And so that's why we're reinvesting in what we're doing.
8:52 is our time. This is the Morning Drill on Stream Television, Armstrong, and the Allegheny News Talk Sports Network. So I'm involved with the organization, and it seems like our season ends end of October, beginning of November. Mm-hmm. And you think, okay, we don't have to pick up again till registration time, which is May. We got a lot of time. Now, here it is. And it's like, I don't think we've had a meeting, or we haven't had enough meetings, you know. So I'm sure for you, with everything that's been going on from last season to now, you almost wish you had a little bit more time to prepare.
We wish we did, but we've been meeting in the off season. We have been meeting all through the winter, and we've been preparing and planning. And this is partially how we've been able to be at this point at right now. So we are very, very grateful for the couple people that are veteran board members, and we've had some new folks that are coming up that we're kind of, you know, preparing, you know, and getting them equipped so that they can step up. So we have been, you know, working very, very hard, but it's really kind of doesn't everybody wish that they have more time before a season starts?
Yes.
But, you know, you make the best with what you have.
What's your favorite part about all of this?
I think it's the kids. I love being down there with the kids and watching progress. I think that's the best part about that. It's not ever about winning. That is one of the best stories. We raffled off a bicycle frame, a jersey, a pair of pants, and gloves. And that is Logan. He's a rider from Erie, and he won it. He raced his first race on his bike last night.
Oh, really?
He did. And the look on his face just says it all. That's myself, and that's Brock. Brock is my boyfriend and our treasurer with the organization. But he was thrilled to pieces. And by the way, he bought one ticket for that raffle. One.
Oh, wow.
one ticket, and he won.
That is so cool.
So, yeah, he didn't buy 10. He bought one. So these are pictures from our banquet. This story, there's a young gentleman in the back in the red and black coat. He is a factory rider. And when I say factory, he rides nationally. But he lives in New York, really, really good guy. Whenever he comes to the track, really, really helpful. He got a prize at our banquet and he offered to redonate it back.
Wow.
He did. And all of those kids that were standing there, he said, I will redonate this back and I will, all of the kids that promise to be alcohol, tobacco, and drug free, they have to make a pledge to do that. And all of those kids that were standing there promised to do that. And then if they promised to do that, they put their names back in and then they were eligible to win that prize. So we have some really awesome things that are happening. There's our top five riders. We had our own jersey designed and made.
Those are pretty cool.
They are very cool. We've never had a jersey on the track. All the other tracks had jerseys, and so we decided that our top five riders, we were going to make our jerseys, and we were going to design them and present them to our top five riders. And if you notice, the top five riders, three of them were girls. And so they all have their numbers on the back of where they stood in the rankings. So that was a really cool thing. And recently we went to New York and three of our riders were representing our track.
Really?
Yeah, they wore their jerseys and represented our track at a big, big race. So it was really, really cool. And it's really awesome to see when you go to a race whenever everybody's like, oh, that's a Drake Wild jersey. Oh, that's a Westmoreland jersey. Oh, that's a South Park jersey. But now we're branded and we're out there. So we've been doing a lot of reinvesting in our community and reinvesting in our kids. So I'm really excited about this year because there's a lot that everybody now recognizes us. Whereas everybody would say, Drakewell, they still exist. Yeah, everybody knows that we're out there. And so that's why we are trying to get more people down here. This year, our push was to send out and blanket the neighboring communities. We sent out 8,000 flyers.
8,000?
8,000. I counted.
Wow.
8,000 flyers to neighboring school districts in hopes that we could get some new riders. We tapped some school districts that haven't been talked to in a long time. And our hope is that we're going to get some new kids coming to our area. So we had a really successful state qualifier again last year. We had 154 riders come to our area, come to our track for our state race. We're hoping again to have that success. We're the last state qualifier, on this side of the state this year. So we're hoping to draw a lot of people because the state series, you have to have four races. And if you have a bad race, you want to hurry up and get one in. And so since we're the last one, everybody wants a good race. So we're hoping that that gives us an edge. So
it sounds like, as you said, the community has really stepped up to help support a lot of organizations in town. You mentioned even businesses like mm-hmm. Oil Creek Plastic stepping up.
Yeah.
I think the Greater Tysville Development Foundation has stepped in and helped out as much as they could.
Yes. They're wonderful. They have been a wonderful connection for us, and they act as our tax pass-through. So anybody who wants to make a donation, they have been they serve and make sure that everybody gets their tax paperwork for us.
Oh, very cool.
Yeah.
So now the question is, how can folks sign up?
All they have to do, they can find us on Facebook. They can find us online and find and access our schedule. If a child wants a child, I say child because that's the bulk of our riders. However, let me amend my statement to say that adults can ride too, and a lot of dads ride with their kids. And the old guy.
And maybe moms can start riding with their daughters.
There actually is a lot of women that are starting to ride again. Not me. I'm a pit mom. I'm pit crew. But there's a lot of movement with where parents are riding with kids. And so what needs to happen is that your first race is always free with USA BMX. So if you want to come down and try it, head down. You're not going to pay a dime and you can give it a whirl. If you decide that you want to do it, then you pay a membership, which is annually, and that covers your membership. You can race at any track in the United States, and then you just simply pay a race fee. But we are now having, we're trying to get a little bit of a rider retention program, and so we're offering a little bit of incentive to our veteran riders to recruit some of their friends.
And Kelly, they're going to have to get online to find out, because we have to go. But Kelly, great to see you. Thank you so much for your passion.
Thank you.
Come back and keep us updated.
Definitely.
What'd you learn today?
All about BMX. This is fantastic.
Kelly, what'd you learn?
That you need to come down and see us.
Okay. Have a great Thursday, everybody. See you back here for the Friday edition. Can't just see